So now let us see what tarantula affects in human body. First is it affects the nerves. Okay. Now what we saw up till now from whatever we learnt about spiders. First, from the structure, what we learned, what was the most important part in the structure? Legs. What in the legs?
Hair.
Why the hair was important? Because they can perceive the slightest amount of vibration. Based on the vibrations, they can detect either it is a prey or what kind of prey is it, or is it a attacker or a danger or a threat. Okay. So, first thing what you see is there is very high amount of sensitivity, very very sensitive nerves to perceive the slightest change in the surroundings, and especially the sensitivity is in relation to touch. Okay, especially sensitive to any kind of touch, slightest touch here and there, they are able to perceive it, they are able to catch it. Secondly, the other sense that is hyperactive, what we saw, what is the other sense that they are able to, what we see? Sound. Yeah, sound, music, you know. So they are very sensitive to sound and music and rhythm. The character of the sound that they need is very rhythmic music. Then what happened? Because of this very, what you say, hypersensitive nervous system, which is able to perceive the slightest amount of change outside, they start to react also very, very sensitively. They are very reactive to everything around. So they are constantly busy. Constantly busy and restless. Constantly doing something. Here or there, there or there. They are constantly receiving one or the other stimulus. And they are, therefore, they are constantly busy and restless. Then what you see? You see the toxic symptoms. What were the toxic symptoms? Yeah? Gangrene. What was the first? What is the first? Pain, irritation and allergic-like symptoms. Right. Then what will happen? Cramps. Cramps. Where? Cramps, convulsions, where? Respiratory, they will cause asphyxia, abdominal cramps and pain. And where? Heart. Heart, they will cause very severe hypertension. And convulsions and tetany. Very good. And then the convulsions can progress to such a level that the blood supply gets cut off. And what you will see? Gangrene and necrosis. Cellulitis. Okay? These were the symptoms we observed. Now, we can understand nerves. Yes. We can understand heart. Yes or no?
Yes.
We can understand spine. Because it is basically a nervous remedy, no? All the nerves are hypersensitive. So anything related to brain and spine will get affected. The nerves are hypersensitive. Right? So the whole spinal cord is sensible. Respiration. Can we understand? Generative sphere. It means sexual sphere. What was the symptoms we saw with in relation to sexual sphere?
Priapism.
Okay. And one observation is that tarantula basically affects the right side. Right side is more prominently affected. Okay. Next. Now let us see the keynotes. First thing what we learned from the legs, we learned that they are hypersensitive, no? So, I have chosen symptoms just in that same sequence. First was what? Hypersensitive. Then what we saw? Hypersensitive, especially in relation to which senses?
Sound
and touch. Then what we saw? because of hypersensitivity, they constantly keep getting stimulus. So they are constantly busy and restless. Okay, then convulsions, cramps, all the toxic symptoms. In the same sequence, I have put the keynotes. Okay, hyperesthesia, least excitement irritates, followed by languid sadness, extremes of tips of fingers. Okay, extreme means extreme sensitivity. Okay, of the tips of the fingers. So they are, you know, we saw now the limbs were very, very hyper sensitive to slightest amount of vibration. Next, slight touch along the spine provokes spasmodic pain in chest and cardiac region. Yes or no? All of you together.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Next, headache, intense, as if thousands of needles were pricking in the brain. Okay, thousands of needles, all these are, you know, common symptoms when nerves are affected. Okay? You got this symptom? Yes or no?
Yes.
Next is adapted to highly nervous organisms, especially choleric affections, where whole body or right arm and left leg are affected. Highly nervous organisms. You get this? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Highly nervous organism, especially choleric. I think it is not choleric. It must be of some writing mistake. It is choric. Chorea. Okay. Chorea affections, where the whole body or right arm and left leg are affected. Okay. What was the opposite? Which remedy we saw? Left shoulder and right leg?
Agaricus.
This is opposite. And remember, tarantula, which side is affected?
Right.
Okay. Next, constant movement of the limb, of the legs, arms, trunk, with inability to do anything, twitching or jerking of muscles. Okay. Now, what is important in this symptom? Can you read? What is characteristic here? If you have heard, tell me, what is peculiar here? Up till now we learned, no? There is what? Restlessness, hyperactivity, hypersensitivity. There is one thing that is little bit more peculiar here. I will read again. Tell me, what is peculiar? Constant movement of the limb, of the legs, arms, trunk, with inability to do anything, twitching and jerking of muscles.
Due to hypersensitivity, the loss of power.
Okay, read next symptom. Leg symptom. Same thing gets highlighted. One more small thing is
constant.
Okay, let us see. I will read, then I will take your suggestion. Restlessness, could not keep quiet in any position. Must keep in motion. Thought walking aggravates all symptoms.
Constant movement.
Constant, we learned, no, busy. Constantly busy, we learned. One more thing. Inability to
do anything.
Do anything, okay. So from that, what you understand? You see this? Must move. What does must move mean? Have to. It is compulsive. I don't want to move. I can't. I have to. So it is what? Compulsive. In control. Uncontrollable. Impulsive. I don't want to move, but I have to move. Okay? Next. Great restlessness, could not keep quiet anywhere, lacks control, erratic, impulsive. Yeah? Are you getting me?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
restlessness, could not keep quiet anywhere, lacks control, erratic and impulsive. Need to constantly moving the hands, feet and head. Now, there are other remedies. Which are the other remedies which have this compulsive movement of limbs, hands and limbs? Zincumbent. Okay? Zincumbent is what? Restless limbs. No. Specific. More specific. Legs. Zincumbent is more restless legs. One more remedy which has restless legs. Medorrhinum. Very good. Two remedies where the restlessness is predominantly in the legs is zincumbent and medorrhinum. What is characteristic of kalibrum? Fidgety of fingers and limb and legs. It is both. In kalibrum, it is both the upper extremity as well as lower extremity. In tarantula, what is it? Whole body, everything. Okay? Then you have wandering pains relieved by warm frictions. Wandering pain relieved by warm frictions. Okay? So, up till now what we learned, there is hypersensitivity which is extremely sensitive to any kind of touch and sound. Now what the symptom is? Better by? Warm frictions means what? Rubbing. Okay? So they want the parts to be rubbed with something warm. That is what makes them feel better. That somehow calms their nerves. Okay?